You can go up on top of the group leg and stay below, whatever you want to do.
Okay, thank you so much.
Go on in.
Your little mat to wipe our feet.
Are we coming to the adorable caboose?
It is very nicely redone.
Oh, the cupolas.
Yeah, this is beautiful.
Stairs, but
oh, it's fine.
It's right up against the engine today.
All right.
Thank you.
Go side, different oops, sides.
Sorry. Oh my goodness. I love it.
This is the best ever.
All right.
Thank you. This is awesome. Yeah.
Mommy's happy. The engine is, the boiler's offset to the, interesting.
This was this is called a Shay locomotive. It was invented by a Michigan lumberman named Jeffrey Shay. Probably built it like in 1870 or came up with design. But finally in 1880, the Lima locomotive works got his design from Shay and started building the Shay locomotive. And the Shay locomotive made the Lima locomotive works very famous. That's what they were known for.
In Sacramento?
Lima, Ohio.
Oh, Lima, Ohio.
Yeah.
gonna go for a little walk through here.
Yeah.
It's so beautiful. And this is a big cargo door, or for wheelchairs, right?
Wheelchairs. Yeah, freight. Yes, cargo.
Freight. You really open up quite a large door. Oh, neat. And these seats are beautiful. Just beautiful. How about that? We got a whole train full of people back there. Cool.
Adjust them any way you want. The pack goes over.
So oh, wow. Do that again. That is really neat.
So you can make it
the for the forward of the trip and the back of the trip.
So all of them do that.
All of them do that. Yeah. These are fantastic. What a great design.
Yeah.
It's even got a bit of an angle to it. That's fantastic. Go upstairs. There, Gwipey. Wow,
oh,
that's my sunglasses. Wow, you really can feel the heat from it. The dry system is on the other side only. Wow, I never saw that from the other place. It's one side drive only. On this side, you got brakes. Got a neat little crane. Got it. This little trip burns 400 gallons of water and about 30 gallons of used motor oil. This locomotive has been converted to run old engine oil from cars and trucks. And when she's not working very well, she burns 40 gallons an hour. When she is working well, she burns 30 gallons an hour. She got a rebuild last winter, so she's in good shape. She's tight. Quite interesting that this big geared drive, 12, they call it 12 wheel drive, but it's only on this side. I guess the axles are straight through. And right now this fella is touching the bearings, and what he can do is he can feel one that's going bad because it'll be just too hot to touch.
So all 12 wheels are driving.
And the pistons are kind of on the side here, or is
that? They took the
pistons. Put them over here, or come back here.
What's going on with the pistons here? The rod, side rods are going to come this way. The shank is coming this way. It's going to go up and down. So it works a lot more efficiently. They need to put multiple pistons so they drive on the down instead of the upper.
You get more torque this way?
Yeah.
Cool. I'm going to grab that microphone from you real quick and then walk down the hill here a bit. All right, shall we go?
She's warm. She's noisy. And she's beautiful. She's got brakes too. Interesting. So when you lift up on that arm, it would pull the brake shoe into the drive surface. And here's our little caboose. Here's an old logging truck of some kind. Well, you got a few bullet holes in it. Must have been able to lift logs onto its back deck or something. Everybody likes to do railway art. This fella's doing railway photography art. Everybody likes locomotives.
This is probably a water car. Maybe that was water. Disconnect and drive the engine around to the back of the train, and the next train they do in an hour is going to drive down that way from opposite the way this one is. And they alternate each time. This guy's got to pull a fair ways in to do that. Oh no, he's got to kind of stop. I wonder how far he's going to go. How many people are pointing cameras at each other? He's gonna go as far as he can. He'll drive the train around. It'll make it around that bus just barely. Thank you very much. And it's our anniversary, 31 years. And this train is quite a bit older than that. That is a piece. So right there is a piece of a log flume. This thing right there, that's a log flume. And this railway from this position worked about 1 mile down the hill to where the mill was. It hauled all the logs to the mill. They trimmed the logs down, and then the logs went into this flume that went 54 miles down to Madera in California, like all the way down to the valley. 54 miles of that. And that's how they transported the logs. Water took them down there. But they had to put a lot of these trees into making that flume. But I guess if you didn't have to pay for the trees. Now, what's going to happen here is engine 10 is going to be removed from this end of the train, disconnect from the caboose, and it's going to drive down to the other. It's going to come onto this track, which is, that's where it parks in there, actually. And then they'll switch the tracks. It parks in there, and they'll switch those tracks, and then they're going to drive it down to the other end. And that's going to happen in about 5 minutes. Switching the tracks over. That looks like it works pretty slick. There'll be three more toots when it comes forward. Or just one. This is gonna come right by. Oh boy. Set boiler on number 10.
ground floor. Look at the president. Now that's gone.
That's amazing.
So now he'll switch over to the other track and he's gonna back up and hook to this. And then the next run goes down the other way. What a deal. What a deal. With that. And we're doing a tug test. Tug test is good. Connect the airlines now. Very nice. Open the airlines. Okay, good. Bunch of checking going on. Oh, we're gonna have to push the train back. It's blocking the road right now. Maybe some toot-toot, a little backing up. He's building up a little bit of steam there. Some pressure. All right, good to back it up and get some toot toot. Here she comes. Thank you.
I guess they're moving it over to this other track.
It's got a wooden front end.
So the thing is, it's a, they have a shaft. You turn it, it keeps spinning.
It's the state of California flag on the far side there. We got a bunch of extra tools here.
It's like a drive shaft.
And it's geared.
Yeah, but
it's geared. It uses a drive shaft and geared. And I think that's got something to do with climbing hills. I've never quite seen that. Look at this drive system. It's crown and pinion gear. Look at that. There is grease coming off this thing everywhere. The ground clearance is
about
4 inches down there. So the pistons are vertical in this train. In this engine, I should say. And gosh, look, there's the crank. And she's just dripping oil, actually. Or water. Probably water. Yeah, that's water. Wow, and the drive shaft goes all the way back. Every single one of these wheels is geared. All the way back. Would you look at that? And again, the tail's made of wood. Back if it's made of wood. I don't know what to say. But I want to go for a ride. It doesn't seem like it's running. Hey, Dee, look at this. No, I'm about to. But look at the drive system on this. It's all geared. And the pistons go up and down on the side. I've never seen anything like it. Look at this thing. I've never seen such a thing. That's got to be for climbing steep hills. Doesn't that look powerful? It looks slow. But it looks very powerful.
Wristband tickets prior to boarding, okay?
They're like cars. Look at these little Ford engines in them. Oh, those are so cool. It's a Ford. That is so cool. These are log benches, if you want to sit in one of these. Oh, there's some spare gears for the engines. Geared. And I guess this is where she parks at night. And number 15 is under major rebuild. Quite a beautiful little facility. Wonder what that's for. It sure looks like a piece of the main, an axle. Looks like a broken axle, which would explain what it's doing there. Here's something. This is the bottom of one of those Fords. This is considered the bottom of one of those Fords. Somebody's rebuilding it. It's getting an all new top.
Here's a donkey engine. So cool. Same principles as a locomotive with this little guy in the valving. So this rod controls the valving that makes that piston either push or pull. The donkey engine, there's a little sign. But they used to skid these things around on the mountain. The basis of logging. I'd like to have one of these. I bet you can build one. No, you'd have to buy the wrenches, but the rest you could probably make. Nah. This is a two-piston donkey engine. It's actually pretty cool. Oh, a neat stove. It's broken, though. Yeah, and with one of those, that dragged logs. Lots of original logging tools here. Probably need those things when the gears get stuck. Pretty neat. And this is like an accessory drive over here, I'm guessing. And an accessory drive capstan winch. Because before you can do your cable, you have to draw out a rope through your pulley and get your cable all the way up the mountain and back. And he's got two different grades of cable on this one, which makes sense. But these aren't a particularly big one. This is like a close in one. This isn't one that's going up and down the mountain. But this boiler is riveted together. Amazing. And look at this, this is like an early sawmill. An early steam saw.
This one, number 10, was built in 1928. Uh-huh. And now she's all brand new. Everybody says she runs like a totally different